Yo, what's up everyone? It's Mark here with M2M Detail Guys. In this video, guys, we're gonna be installing some windshield tint for my wife. Merry Christmas, woman. And that's all you get. So anyway, guys, let's get straight into it. We got the dryer sheet on the window. You did see I did flip the film on accident right there when I was laying down, so we gotta dry up that little middle piece a little bit with the heat gun. And now we're just gonna be shrinking the film. So guys, if you're new to window tinting, best thing I can tell you guys is practice on shrinking. Take your time. Do a bunch of windshields on your own vehicle, do a bunch of stuff on your own car. Just get as much practice in as you can before you start charging customers for it. And I don't suggest charging people cheap and doing bad jobs. So get your practice in before you start charging your customer and do a good job and spend time. In the beginning, you want to be very careful about lint, debris, and make sure you're cleaning, you got the right tools you need, and you're comfortable charging for the job and you know you could do it. So, as always, guys, practice makes perfect. Just get a lot of time in shrinking film, you know, fixing issues. If you did get a piece of lint, can you pull the film up? Can you fix a crease or, you know, anything like that? You want to make sure you know how to handle it, or do you just got to start over and do a new piece of film? You want to know that before you start doing it for customers. So we got the film all shrink, guys. We're going to pull it up on the glass right here. We're going to weed it out, and then we're going to trim back the corners a little bit all the way around the film. Because we are doing reverse roll, I find it a lot easier if the film's not overlapping everywhere. So you want a tight bottom. The top, not so much, but the bottom and the sides, the less you have around your cut, the easier it is to reverse roll it. If you have an inch or 2 inches on the bottom, you're going to be fighting that as you reverse roll it across the windshield. And always, guys, make sure you guys are controlling your water flow. You have your soak rope in there. We got some dash towels right here, guys. They work great. Put a link in the description for the dash towels. I really like them. They work great, guys. They're like 2 feet by 5 feet. They work awesome. I got 3 of them. And then the soak ropes are soak shield. They work great too. I'll put a link in the description for that. And right now, guys, we just did our prep. So we did the wash, the scrub, and then we wiped it off with a lint-free towel and any areas that we may hit with the film. So the rear view mirror bracket, we wiped that down just so if we do touch it, that's not gonna be a bunch of dirt getting into our film. And then we just do a spray squeegee spray, of course. And now, guys, we are doing the reverse roll. Not sure what happened with my camera, guys. It was like doing a time lapse and then it just went into like live. So not cool. So right now we have to speed up the live. So it might look a little bit different. Sorry about that. I'll keep a closer eye next time I do one, get a better footage for you guys. As you guys are reverse rolling it, you want to be gentle with the film, guys. You don't want to cause any creases as you're pulling the backing paper off. And you know, right now we're just moving all the air out, so make sure you don't have big old air bubbles as you're squeegeeing it, because that will mess you up or get some distortion in the film and possibly crease the film, and then you're going to start all over again. So guys, while I'm doing windshields, I do little by little. As you see, as I'm squeegeeing, I just work the film across. It's just the way I do it. I know you could do big strokes and stuff and don't be afraid of the film. I do, but I don't know, I'm just comfortable like that. So I do my little strokes and make sure if there's any air, the air builds up. I'm not really fighting it or coming back into my line after I squeegee it. So like I said, guys, make sure you got the right tools, because some of the bottom corners on back windows and windshields, guys, you're gonna need some special tools for that. Make sure you got everything you do need and watch a bunch of videos as you go for it on window tinting. So guys, we're just cleaning up this passenger side real quick before we move on to the driver's side. Squeegee that out. And I like to start right at the rear view mirror if I don't remove it. Like this one has a radar sensor and everything up there, so the tint goes around it. So I like to squeegee up right there so I'm not fighting debris or fingers coming back into the film. And you guys will notice as you practice, when those fingers pop up, they do pull in some debris, especially when they're above and the water is coming down into it. Even on the side doors and gaskets on the side, you will notice debris come back up into your tint. So guys, be aware of that, get your practice. So now we're just doing our final pass, guys. We're doing one more hard pass to make sure there's no air and solution left behind. It's always gonna be solution in there, guys. You can't ever get all the solution out. It will dry out over the next couple days. And then you wanna heat up all your edges and seal them down a little bit. You know, just see what you're dealing with. You wanna make sure the film lays down nicely. On this RAV4, guys, this 2021, by the way, it has a huge dot matrix all the way around the windshield. Not cool, guys. I don't like dot matrices. So we're gonna have to spend a little bit extra time. There's a huge finger up there on that right or the driver's side dot matrix. So that's why I'm heating it from the outside. We're gonna get that tacked down, not play with that anymore. So make sure if you guys are dealing with dot matrices, you make sure you clean that up, make sure you put a little extra time in there. We don't sand them down or anything.
All right, guys, so real quick walk around, let you guys check it out. So that will be the 70% Suntech CXP. You see, we still gotta heat this up a little bit more. Dot matrices, the dot matrix is really tough for have the window tint to like stick to. So we'll go through there, make sure everything's sticking down. Overall, guys, we are looking really good. Just gonna work on this bottom corner. The other bottom corner is pretty much done, and then we'll just double check everything. Hey, check this out though. Look at that mirror. That thing goes all the way up. Is that a trip? That's a trip. Okay, guys. Well, as always, appreciate you watching. Mark out.